Hey guys, Joe back again, another episode of Gettin Junk Done, and today we have Tina with us, my beautiful wife. She has not been in any videos for a number of weeks/months. It's been a while, so the idea that we have for this video was actually hers, so I'm going to let her explain it, but a little bit of a background. We have a plot of land in upstate New York that we're slowly converting to a future homestead where we're going to be living off-grid and off the land as much as we can. And that's where we are right now. Now, it's very cold outside.
It's 30 degrees outside.
It's 30-some degrees.
It's cold.
We have a lot of that to get used to. But okay. At the same time, that's why we're in our little shelter that we have. Yeah. So that's the beautiful background that we have. It's just a little warmer in here. So anyway, this video is the very beginning of a series that we're starting. And I'm going to let Tina explain it. But in the meantime, while watching the video, if you have any ideas to contribute, suggestions, or anything like that, leave a comment down below.
Nicely.
A nice comment.
Nice comment.
Nice comment.
Please.
Yeah. We know you internet trolls can be a little weird sometimes. Anyway, so leave a comment down below with suggestions to help us out to further this series even more. Yep. All right. Tina, you're up.
Okay. So it's basically going to be a $50 a month kind of shopping haul, if you will. When we move to New York, I'm going to be retiring. I retire in less than 790 days.
But who's counting?
Yeah, exactly. we don't know yet with Joe if it's just going to be the YouTube thing or if it's going to be his landscaping business or a little combination of everything, or both. But what it's going to be, basically, these videos, it's to help us prepare for the move.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, because just with resources and money going to be limited when we do move up here, we want to see what we can do now to stockpile for the move.
Right, so we kind of want to invest in certain things ahead of time and spread out the cost so it's not such a shock to our wallet when we do move here. So we're not scrambling. We need sugar, we need flour, we need,
rice,
ammunition, we need anything like that. So we're going to start buying things like that now. And we decided $50 a month is a good start.
It's realistic. I mean, it's not like it's, you know, $50 you can blow in two visits to Wawa or, you know.
Yeah, it's
on
a minimal.
On nothing. Yeah,
it's a minimal cheap expense that we probably all lose it on coffee every morning anyway. So.
You know it. But so basically, we came up with the first month is going to be first aid supplies.
Right.
I have quite a few kitchen accidents a week. Joe has some.
I'm always
issues.
Cutting myself yeah. open or busting a finger
yeah.
or something.
So this is going to be a good way for us. Just it's kind of easy, a good way to start just to get a feel for these shopping haul videos.
And it's probably something smart to have on hand now anyway. First aid supplies is never a bad idea
yeah.
to have.
So whether it be gauze or tape, Band-Aids, peroxide,
yeah.
Vaseline, something as simple,
yeah.
or anything.
That'll be the first month.
Yeah, that's going to be pretty easy. So that's going to be for the month of November.
Right.
The month of December, we decided on long-term food prepping supplies, storage supplies.
Yeah.
Whether it be canning jars, vacuum sealing bag, Mylar, oxygen absorbers, anything of that nature, anything to or food-grade buckets, whatever
yeah.
to store.
Yeah,
first aid
the stuff that
anything.
You would the stuff that you would use to store
correct.
The food long-term.
Yes.
And in January's video.
It's going to be food. I've seen
food.
For the past couple years now. After Christmas sales, for some reason, Target usually is expensive for flour or just little things like that. We actually went into a Target, I think it was a couple days or
yeah.
a week after Christmas, and for some reason they had flour that was good until this year, the end of 2018. It was good. It was only 20-some cents.
Yeah,
so
for a big bag.
Yeah.
So
it was a 5-pound bag of flour for 20-some cents. So I asked him if there was a limit. He said no, the gentleman that was helping us.
But
so,
we still only got a couple.
I think I only got 6 or 7
yeah.
maybe, and that was it. So my plan this year, or next year, technically January of 2019, will be our food prepping $50 haul for long-term storage. I've been doing my due diligence on educating myself and doing some preparing of my own and seeing how to.
We're basically prepper light right now. We're still learning.
I guess.
You know, we have some things in motion. We have some food storage. We have some ammunition storage and things like that. But it's very, very
minimal right now.
Yeah, it's at the beginning stages,
very much.
I would think.
Yeah.
So we want to carry that over to in the next few years when we do decide to move here full time, that we got to be ready.
Yeah.
We got to have this stuff.
I plan
ready
on making a lot of bread, a lot of our own food. So I don't want to have to run out every week or every month or spend a lot of money in getting flour, sugar, anything.
Right.
So anybody with any ideas, especially for flour, sugar, I understand that. But for flour, I know some people say freeze it because of bugs, and same with rice because of weebles, whatever these guys are. So you freeze it for a couple days before you vacuum seal it, whatever. Anybody that has any ideas or suggestions, please let me know, because I'm extremely interested in it. And there's a overabundance of YouTube videos out there that kind of contradict each other. So
yeah, trying to sift through the information is a little tough at times to find out what the truth is. So I think you get the idea of us each month putting out an additional video of what we've collected for $50 and only $50 for that month.
Yep.
And each month would kind of be a theme.
Yes, and I want to kind of do this. $50 $50 to some people is a lot of money. But when you look at it, it's just $50. It's $600 a year to invest in our future.
Yeah.
We're prepping for our future.
Minimal the cost, move. And you just spread it out over time. And if we do this...
I want to do this every month until we move.
Every month until we move is the goal. We might skip a month or two, depending on expenses and surprises and things
life.
Like that. Yeah, life gets in the way sometimes of... like plans.
Yeah.
So I think you see where we're going with this. And if you have, besides those first 3 months, we have a number of ideas that we're going to be talking about.
Yeah. These are the first couple months that we've
just to get us rolling.
Yeah. But I would like to get some feedback from everybody out there.
Right.
Especially if you have maybe some more experience than we do on this, what would be some additional things? Like, okay, is it nails or screws, or I know that might seem kind of weird, but sandpaper, I don't know. That's his.
Yeah.
Building materials.
Yeah, she'll be doing a lot of these videos herself.
Yeah.
I'll be behind the camera in some of the cases and vice versa. So,
ammo was a big one, I know. We're going to go 1 month. I know $50 is not going to take us along, you know, it's not going to get us a lot with ammo. But if we do that maybe every other month or every 2 months just for ammo.
1 month we'll focus on shotgun shells.
Yeah.
And then we'll do
maybe another food
like
223
for another month. And then maybe, you know, hunting rounds. You get the idea.
Yeah.
Just... we'll pick at it.
We want to push him before we move.
Yeah.
And I know we'll both feel a little more secure and a little, you know, better having that when we do.
Absolutely. So I think you see where this is going. And if you have any ideas for a monthly theme.
Yes.
So.
Let us know.
Let us know what you think a
The most requested. How about this? We'll do that. So 1 month. So how about not the first three? The first 3 months, I'm kind of already dead set on that. I like these kind of three themes.
But that gives them 3 months.
Yeah. So you have 3 months to come up with our fourth month video. The most requested, we'll do a $50 shopping haul on that and see what we can get out of $50. How about that?
Yeah. So we'll look at the comments if we...
if we get
if
any.
We get any. We'll look at the comments and decide which one... has gotten the most attention or the one that shows up most often.
Yes.
So if like 5 or 6 people say the same thing and I only get 5 or 6 video comments, I think we should probably just go with that.
Sure. Sounds good to me.
So the other way we can use this $50 is if we don't use all 50, the remaining balance rolls over to the following month. So whatever change or a few bucks here and there build up, we could have a $75 or $100 1 month thing. Splurge.
Ooh.
It'll be fun.
It's exciting.
Yeah. All right, we're going to wrap it up with that. So I hope you guys liked this video. And if you did, please click like, comment, share, and subscribe.
Yes.
And as always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram at Gettin' Junk Done. Mm-hmm. Tina?
Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Mudder Farms, which is M-U-D-D-E-R Farms. I don't know if there's an underscore. Go to his.
Go to my Instagram
at Gettin'
Junk Done. And you can find her Instagram.
I have more followers than he does.
Well, with that, we're going to call it a night. Thanks, everybody. Take care.
Good night.